May we ask now, DPDEA, kung meron ba kayong pwedeng i-submit, ipakitang report dito sa committee ito?
Yes, Your Honor. We will show to you how the drug list came about. And this is very crucial in relation to the story of Ms. Garma.
So, in other words, DG, masusuportahan nyo yung sinasabi ni Colonel Garma?
As far as the making of the drug list, sir, is concerned.
Okay, will you submit to us or are you going to make a presentation?
We will give you a copy, sir, but again, we ask for your indulgence. Please find time to look at it because we assure you that after we finish the presentation, you will understand how this list came about.
And, sige, please.
Yes, sir, I would like to request our Director for Intelligence, Director Bitong, sir, to brief.
Okay. So, with the indulgence of the members of the committee, we will allow the PIDEA to make this presentation or this report before the QUADCOM. Please proceed.
Please bear with me, sir, as I try to read it so that I can deliver it crisply and clearly. This is a base. We tried to be very faithful to the data that were made available to us. Next. So actually, sir, what I'm showing is the history of the PRRD's list. In several occasions, the former president showed lists and mentioned drug personalities in his public appearances. On August 7, 2016, he mentioned Mayor Mabilog along with 159 others. Next. In December 2016, the first president drug list, or popularly known as PRRD list or narco list, was obtained. On September 28, 2017, the second list was obtained. This was merged with the first list. The total personalities combined were now at 6,191. On October 19, 2017, during the technical working group meeting, the TWG included in the list the personalities mentioned by PRRD on August 7, 2016. Thus, the total 6,221. 30 out of 159 new personalities were added. The others also mentioned were already in the list. In March 2018, the third list with 6,623 was received. The first, second, and third list was combined, removing redundancies, resulting to a total of 6,562 personalities. During this period, series of intelligence workshops, the crafting of policies and guidelines, and remedied subcommittee meetings were conducted. It was on 28 May 2019 when the President's drug list was renamed Interagency Drug Information Database, or IDID. From May 14, 2021 to April 7, 2022, three remedied committee meetings were conducted. Out of 1,046 POIs adjudicated by the remedied committee, only 885 were approved. 600 POIs recommended for deletion, 249 for relegation to suspense file, and 36 for retention. And 153 POIs remain pending. This is the current IDID, the working database that is the product of remedied from the first, second, and third list. Upon the assumption of PBBM, the committee members conducted several consultation meetings. A letter signed by current SILG as chairman, the former SILG, as chairman of remedied committee proposing that the solution of the remedied guidelines and procedures was forwarded to the Office of the President on May 24, 2024. This is yet to be approved. Meanwhile, the different regional adjudication committees are continuously deliberating their IDID. In our effort to come up with a comprehensive study, PIDEA obtained the following e-copies, as shown. When PIDEA was tasked to study the origin of PRRD list, PIDEA gathered versions from other sources, as shown. First on the list is the new target list. It is the file name. It was recovered from old PIDEA files. The original list in August 2020 was acquired by the Director General of PIDEA on September 2024. The PRRD list, pro-NIR, was recovered by the Deputy Director General for Operation, ASEC Renato Gumban. And the IDID list is the working database maintained by PIDEA, processed from first, second, the PRRD pronouncement, and the third list. I will show you, sir, the details of the different list. Going to the details, shown are the properties and contents of the different list. Comparing the five Excel e-copies, we come up with the following results. New target list and original list are the same with 3,981 names. The August 2020 and PRRD list pro-NIR have minor differences. File name PRRD list pro-NIR has only 31 worksheets compared to August 2020 with 32 because it contains worksheet NIR. IDID, the official list of remedied committee, has a total of 6,276. Let me just note that Attorney Wesley A. Barayuga, the PCSO official killed on July 30, 2020, was included in August 2020 in PRRD list pro-NIR, but never in IDID. Going deeper, sir, you will note, sir, that the new target list is authored by PNP-CIDG as well as the original list, PNP-CIDG. And the next, the August 2020, is authored by a certain Iyanism as well as PRRD list pro-NIR. While the IDID has no more author because this is a working database. Upon checking the properties of the same five Excel files, particularly the original list, it has the PNP-CIDG and Yanism as the authors, four of which were created last July 25, 2016, while the IDID was created last November 15, 2022, because, as I said, it is a working database and properties change every updating. The next slide. This is what we were talking about earlier. This slide shows notable differences among the lists. On the left is worksheet found in the new target list and original list. This contains five levels with description and a column for amount. On the right is worksheet found in file name August 2020 and PRRD list pro-NIR. These have only four levels with description and an evaluation. These do not have the amount column. In the IDID list, all these worksheets are not included. Next. This slide is a photo gallery of high-value target found in the list. On the left, the new target list, original list, and IDID list contain fewer photos then the one on the right with file name August 2020, NPRRD list pro-NIR. On the next slide, shows a photo gallery of alleged Binondo personalities found on the list. Just like the previous slide, the new target list, original list, and ID list on the left contain fewer photos than the one on the right with file name August 2020 NPRRD list pro-NIR. In both lists, DAPICOL personalities Jackson Lee and Wong Meng Pin are included. Our findings. There is indeed the President's drug list, commonly known as PRRD list. All four lists obtained were authored on July 25, 2016. File name, new target list, and original list are both authored by PNP CIDG. The file name PRRD, Pro-NIR, and August 2020 have same author, Yianism. These were recently obtained and did not undergo official validation by the remedied. There are many inconsistencies and differences between the different lists. The counts of personalities vary. There are double or triple entries, many aliases, insufficient details. The tab high-value target of personalities with some names on the picture gallery are not included in the list. There are also inconsistent recapitulation and numbering on the sheets. The three Chinese killed in DAPICOL are included in the list. The original list contained the amount column. Mayor Mabilog was not included in the original list until October 19, 2017, 2 months after second list was received. And attorney Wesley Barayuga was included only in August 2020 and PRRD list pro-NIR, but never in IDID or the official list. That ends our briefing, sir.
Mr. Chair, can I have just some clarificatory question?
Please proceed.
Yeah, thank you very much. Just to the PDEA, nabanggit niyo po kanina, based on what I gather, it was a list that was having a lot of revisions from the time that it started, correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
So, if it was being revised continuously, we were seeing deaths left and right since 2016 onwards.
Yes, Your Honor.
So, how can we now say that those deaths and those operations were indeed validated true drug personalities? If the list itself that served as the basis of the PNP to implement was not validated, nor was it final in nature.
That was the predicament that we had while we were trying to analyze the lists, Your Honor, because we found out that, let us just take for example the first list or the original list. It was sent to PDEA, it was studied by PDEA, and when it was submitted back to the palace, that is what I understand, a second list would be given back to PDEA. And it was observed that there would be names included in the list that was being sent back to PDEA. So parang, ano sir, we checked on the list, we sent it forward, we sent it upwards for them to check on it, hoping that there would be no more names included, but it was the opposite. There would be names again that would be included. And so this continued until the third list. And so as not to miss anything, the lists were already combined with each other to come up with the August 2020 list, removing the names that were redundant or maybe there were deaths already, so they were removed from the list already. So that was how the list evolved, Your Honor.
Do we have somebody from the CHR here, Mr. Chair? Do we have a representative from the CHR?
Yes, earlier they were here, but after the interview with the victims earlier, we allowed them to be excused
okay.
for this
particular... I just wanted to know lang, Mr. Chair, kasi base sa sinabi ng PDEA, it was around 2020 where, you know, a working draft that was actually validated was finalized, more or less, correct?
Your Honor, just to make a clarification, the file name is dated August 2020, but as early as 2019, the file name is only August 2020, Your Honor, but as early as 2019, because after the NSC,
yes, sir.
General Bitong will explain, Your Honor.
Yes, sir. Actually, starting January 4 of 2016, sir, it already undergo a TWG deliberation. There is no remedy yet. It has
Mr.
not
Chair,
yet
Mr.
been
Chair,
approved.
January 2016?
No, sir. It's January 2017. January 4, 2017.
So meaning, it was on July 1 that the former president assumed office. So it was not until the following year of the first month, January 2017, that this list was, how do you say it, processed, correct?
Sir, may I? Actually, sir, starting July 4 of 2016, 5 days after the assumption, the president started showing already and announcing, showing in public the president's list.
So, what was the basis of that list?
We only got the official list on January 4 of 2017, the first list.
Colonel Patay. Di ba, tanong ko lang, di ba sabi nyo kanina na-assign kayo sa Davao
Del Norte po, Mr.
Tapos,
Chair.
Tapos, pagkatapos ng assignment nyo doon, anong taon yon?
Until 2016 July, Mr. Chair.
Ha?
Until 2016 July.
Can you speak louder?
2016 July, Mr. Chair.
2016 July. Tapos, in 2016 July, saan po kayo nailipat?
Sa dito po sa NCRPO Station 6 QCPD, Mr. Chair.
NCRPO Station 6. Nung kayo po ang naipwesto dito, gaano katagal po kayo naglingkod dito po sa NCRPO Station 6?
11 yata yun, Mr. Chair. 11 months from July to September, if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Chair.
Doon po sa kabuuan ng 11 buwan, maalala nyo po ba kung ilan ang drug operations ninyo na nagresulta sa pagkamatay ng suspect?
Hindi ko po mabigay yung exact figure, Mr. Chair.
But more or less?
Hindi ko po ma-estimate. Last time, Mr. Chair, previous hearing, may guidance na po dito na ang listahan po ay I think that it was submitted yata sa dito sa committee na to, Mr. Chair.
Yes, can you give me a ballpark figure?
I was not able to look at the report, Mr. Chair. I cannot give the figure, Mr. Chair. Makamali po ako.
Chairman Paduano, maybe you can tell me.
Anyway, just to correct your statement, Colonel Patay, of course, baka nakalimutan mo na, you stayed in NCRPO, QC, station in
Batasan.
Station 6 nga, pero QC. Diba? Quezon City.
Yes,
you were assigned here in the NCRPO July 1.
Yes, Mr.
Chair. And July 4, you were assigned as Station 6 Commander. Tama?
If this records...
Anyway, yes, anyway, yung transfer mo pabalik doon sa CIDG?
CIDG after my assignment dito sa Station 6, Mr. Chair.
Correct. And that is September. Yes, so more, Mr. you stayed in Station 6 more than a year?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
More than a year.
More than a year.
During the previous hearing sa Committee on Human Rights, as reported, the data shows that more than 100 was killed, which is drug-related operations.
Mr. Chair, I cannot confirm or deny that data.
And that is the data presented to us, not you, but the CHR.
Okay. Thank you very much, Congressman Paduano. So anyway, so Colonel Patay, doon sa panahon na in-implement niyo po itong madugong gera laban sa droga, sabi na nga po na mahigit 100 ng buhay na nasawi. Ano po ang pinagbasihan po ninyong listahan?
That was based on the reports from the BADAC, Mr. Chair, and intel reports coming from the intel of the our unit, Mr. Chair.
Intel of the PNP.
There was already a list in the stations produced or stored coming from the BADAC, Mr. Chair, because during that time the barangay officials were very cooperative on that campaign, Mr. Chair.
So anyway, ang akin lang pong medyo nakakadala ng konting, hindi naman konti, kasi ang malaking pangamba, Mr. Chairman, is PDEA said that it was a working draft, this list, that was used as basis to implement the drug war. And it was not until 2020 was an interagency task force was created to have a processing draft of a list. And that was 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020. That was 4 years after the assumption. How many lives were lost during that time? The question now is, doon sa mga namatay at inoperate, ilan doon ba talaga yung inosente at hindi dapat nasa listahan? Kasi yung mismong listahan na pinagbabasihan, hindi pa nga final in nature, Mr. Chair. So, siguro, Mr. Chair, one of my requests is for PDEA to give us this list and we can cross-match it to those individuals that were, how do you say it, unjustly lost their lives, and then we can see really the loopholes in the implementation of this drug war. That's my point, Mr. Chair. Marami
salamat. Salamat, Congressman Suarez. So the next to interpolate is Congressman Dan Fernandez. You have 10 minutes.
Okay. salamat po. So we have invited yung sa PCSO, no? We are very sorry, no, na turnover overturn tayo ng mga events and even all other officers from PNP, sila Balindog, sila Villela, Crialdo. Maybe I'll just limit my question kay GM Rohina Garma, no? Kasi medyo ngayon lang namin na-receive yung affidavit. So, meron lang akong gustong tanong dito, Ma'am Rohina, no? But of course, hindi namin po natin na stop, Mr. Chairman, yung sa PCSO dahil meron din po mga issues doon that need to be clarified, no? Ma'am Rohina, kasi dito sa sinabi mo rito that tinawagan ka ni Presidente, former President Duterte, 5 a.m. in the morning. And during the time that you were with him, kayo lang bang dalawa?
No, Mr. Chair.
Sinong kasama nyo sa sasakyan?
Ah, yeah, it's just the two of us, sir, Mr. Chair.
So, ikaw ang sumundo kay former president?
I have my vehicle kasi, so nag-drive ako papunta doon. And then sabi niya, sasakay na lang siya sa loob ng sasakyan.
So you were driving the car?
Yes, sir.
And this is a usual thing for you to do with the former president when you were still the chief of police of Davao?
Hindi naman, Mr. Chair.
So, hindi siya regular na ginagawa niyo na sinusundo mo siya doon? Or, no? Kasi no, very no. Unusual yung...
No, Mr. Chair, that was the first time.
First time to?
Pinapunta ako doon, yes.
At nagtaka ka rin dahil presidente na siya noon. President-elect na siya.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And this was May 2016. Hindi pa siya nag-oath.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
And do you have some inkling on what you were going to talk about or wala naman?
Hindi ako nagtatanong kasi, Mr. Chair. I just complied with the instructions.
Bakit ka pinagkakatiwalaan ng former president? I was hindi naman confused, but suddenly parang lang nabibigla lang ako because you were denying your relationship with her, with him, right? Even there are issues about you and the former president having a romantic relationship in accordance to what we have read dun sa mga issue that was tackled by Montulfo. You will be denying that you have a relationship with the former president?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
At yung pagtitiwala sa iyo, paano nag-start yung pagtitiwala? Kasi there must be something on it. That's the reason why he called you and he was with you. Ano yun?
Mr. Chair, kung titingnan mo kasi yung structure ng officer sa Davao City Police Office, I am the most senior female police officer. And then the first time that I reported also sa Davao City Police Office when he was the mayor and I was just a lieutenant during that time, it appears that I'm the first PNPA officer who was assigned in Davao City. I think it was his first time to encounter. I was only 23 years old during that time. So parang naging familiar din siya sa akin. And then when I work sa Davao City Police Office, na mayor siya or naging vice mayor siya, perhaps siguro nakita niya rin yung how I work, Mr. Chair. Until eventually, nung naging senior na po yung rank ko as an admin officer, I would attend mga conferences and I am the only female officer present in the room. And I used to be the spokesperson of the station commanders because nahiya sila magtanong.
So in other words, matagal kayong nagkasama sa trabaho. It's all about work.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Walang something that niligawan kanya or naging...
To some, it would appear na parang nanligaw, but for me, it's just naman po, just work, Mr.
Okay.
Chair.
Dito kasi may binabangkit ka, no? Yung, kanina na-mention na yun, yung tatlong level, no? Yung patayan, tapos babayaran, tapos yung pondo doon sa plant operation. Kasi binanggit mo dito na mayroong pondo para sa plant operation. And the Congress is allotting funds for a COPLAN. Meron tayong pondo sa COPLAN eh.
Yes.
Why merong pang pondo na binibigay? Is this a separate fund aside from the COPLAN that are being utilized by the station? It's all the same?
Yeah. Mr. Chair, in reality sa ground, wala naman talagang punto binibigay ang PNP sa COPLAN. Yung mga COPLAN lang na napupunduhan, national level yan kung meron man. But station level, pag magkanda ka ng mga simultaneous service of search warrant, ikukoplan mo yan because you need the support of other agencies, you will deploy agents, you need money, and you need to pay your agents. So, gagawa ka ng COPLAN, hindi po yan ina-approve ng PNP. So, ang ginagawa ng local police, they would go to the mayor and ask for funding ng COPLAN. Ganyan po ang normal na nangyayari po sa ground, Mr. Chair. Hindi po yan pupundahan ng provincial office o na regional office.
So, in other words, walang pondo na nilalaan sa bawat istasyon kapag nagkakaroon sila ng COPLAN. At the PNP or the yung mag-ooperate ng Copland have to source it out. No? So, yun ang sinasabi mo. So, sino si Mooking? Kasi may sinabi ka dito, si a certain Mooking contacted you. Is he Mooking Espino?
Parang Espino, Espina. Yeah, it's a stop po ni, ano po yan, sa City Hall, sa office po ni Sir Bongo during that time.
Stop to ni Senator Bongo?
Yes po, during that time.
Anong pangalan niya?
Actually, I forgot, Mr. Chair, but she's known with that name, Mooking.
Yeah, and here, ano, no,
Espina,
may...
Espina or Espino.
Anyway,
it can be verified anyway.
Siguro, Mr. Chairman, to give clarity, you know, on this statement made by Rohina Garma, let's invite this Mooking Espino, you know, in the next hearing. No? Okay. And, sige po, Mr. Chair.
Comsec, please take note and send invitation for our next Quadcom hearing.
Mr. Chairman, I think that certain Mooking is assigned during the time from Davao. Dinala po sa Malacanang. I think he's USEC doon sa PMS. Kindly check na lang, Comsec.
Would you know the complete and full name of Mooking? So we can check the records already. Comsec, please coordinate with the PMS and invite the name Mooking.
And on number 12, no, binabanggit mo dito that you learned from Arthur Nasolis via phone that Leonardo had been summoned by the president and was instructed to proceed to Mandaya Hotel in Davao for a meeting. I think, Mr. Chairman, we need to really ask the PNP to look for Arthur Nasolis. What is the status of Arthur Nasolis with regards to this hearing, Mr. Chairman?
Yes, earlier we asked Colonel Cunanan, our liaison to the Philippine National Police, to coordinate with the new CIDG chief, General Torre, and help the committee locate SPO for Arthur Nasolis. He's very material in this investigation, and we need his testimony before this Quadcom, General Torre.
Mr. Chairman, was he cited in contempt already?
Was cited in contempt na.
He was, yes, he was already cited okay. In contempt, and there was an order for his arrest.
Thank you so much, Mr. Chairman. Number 14, Rohina, you declined the invitation of Leonardo to join the task force. Kasi dito sinasabi mo, nag-create ng task force. So you declined, why?
I don't have experience, kasi wide experience with regards to that, Mr. Chair. And during that time, there was an instruction and we had a meeting in Davao, the President Leonardo Bongo and I was there, I was called. There was a plan actually that I will join the PMS to handle the police and military matters. So hindi ako talaga pwede din doon, but eventually hindi naman din natuloy lahat ang plano, and hindi din ako sumali sa as a staff sa Malacanang, and hindi rin ako sumali po dun sa group. And then an order kasi was issued na rin sa akin to report sa CIDG after my schooling.
And what happened doon sa DPWH, you involved yung mga classmates mo, sila Bakay, Bilela, Grialdo, Tuson, and Duenas.
Yes, Mr.
But
Chair.
There was no meeting at all in accordance with your...
Yes, sa amin po, walang pumasok. Kwentuhan lang talagang ano po, sir. Separate room po kasi kami, so kami-kami lang po ang nag-usap, magka-classmate po.
And in accordance with your affidavit, number 19, after the courtesy call, which happened in DPWH, Leonardo informed me that the structure of the intended task force would undergo changes. Ano yung changes na yun?
Nung una po kasi, yung ginawa pong parang structure is masyadong, what do you call this? Very structured po siya talaga, na merong head, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, and maraming staff. So, ang nangyari po is na-change, naging simple na lang. Naging simple na meron ng in-charge, and then meron lang handle, mag-handle ng mag-verify siguro, mag-document, and etc. So, hindi na siya tulad na may Luzon na task force, Visayas, o Mindanao, which is
so, nakita mo yung, ano, yung structure na yun? Nakita mo yung structure na yun?
Yung original structure, nakita ko po, sir, kasi nga ako po yung nag-arrange ng meeting para yeah. i-discuss. Pero yung second na simple na, parang wala nang structure kasi naka parang in addition to your function, parang ganyan na lang po nangyari sa IDG. Ito yung task mo, ito yung task mo, ito yung tasking mo.
So, kasi we have received a structure that you have submitted to us.
That is how the flow looks lang po. It's a diagram but not the structure.
Hindi
ito
pinaka-structure.
No, it's just a diagram how communication flows. Yes, Mr. Chair. It's just a communication flow actually.
Okay, from the top to the bottom
appeared,
level.
Yes, it would appear that.
All right,
way.
So just wanted to inform the body that we have received a diagram of how the money flows, no?
The communication
flows, and
yes, and it would appear also the money would come and.
So we will go with that. No, we will go with that. So, dito sa task force na to. Oh, sige, go ahead.
With the intelligence of Chairman Dan, kasi ganito to po yun, pagkaintindi ko, si Colonel Rinaldo proposes a task force, pero masyadong mabigat, di ba? Too heavy, di ba?
Yes po.
Now, ang implementation ng war on drugs, ang ginawa na lang po per unit, per region, per province, per city, in which yung assignment of those trusted or quote-unquote war machine will be assigned individually. Tama po? Tapos, yung structure na yung diagram na pinakita mo, yun yung sistema ng reporting. Tama?
Yes po.
And at the same time, yun yung diagram that the flow with regards to reporting and the reward system.
Yes, Mr.
Oh, so ang assignment, kasi kanina tinanong si Colonel Patay, who assigned you, etc., etc. So, Colonel Patay, actually, of course, manggagaling yun sa R1 o sa yung sa personnel dito. But, Colonel Patay was assigned in QC in that situation na wala pong task force. Colonel Patay was handpicked to be assigned in CRPO and particularly in QC. Parang ganon, di ba? Yung specific na magiging daloy, Colonel Garma? Ma'am? Per assignment?
Sir,
per individual?
Pakiulit, sir.
Ang sinasabi ko po, yung assignments of personnel or officers is based on the concentration of drugs, no? At the same time, wala pong task force dahil individual lang assignment ng bawat trusted individual that should implement such Davao model. Ika nga.
I'm not too familiar po kung ganun ang lahat ng setup, but to some, nangyayari po yun. E to some po naman po, dala-dala sila ng PD, dala-dala din po sila ng RD.
Of course, I understand.
Yes,
if the PD is part of the selected people that will be implementing such directive, di ba? Yung war on drugs, tama?
Lahat po kasi required na mag-implement.
Kaya nga, pero ang ibig ko sabihin,
yes,
for example, si Juan de la Cruz is in Negros o Bacolod City. Pag nandun yung bolto, no, ng drug transactions and activities, eh kung si Juan de la Cruz is now the city director of that city, maintain siya, di ba? But in the case of Colonel Patay, for example, kasi ganito na lang po, nandito naman lahat, no, sila, except for Colonel Bilina. Dito na po, si Marcos nandito rin. Ito, ano na lang tayo dito? Kasi you cannot lie the data and the records in your assignment. Example, Carol Patay. In your case, 2017.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
You were assigned here. O, sinong bulit-bit sa'yo? Who is the QCPD the time?
General Elizar, Mr. Chair.
General Elizar?
Elizar, Mr. Chair.
O, during your time as a junior officer, do you have any assignments under Elizar?
None, Mr. Chair.
O, none? O, kita mo? You were assigned here not because you were brought or asked by General Elizar. You are brought here to implement this project. Ganon po, kahit yung Colonel Marcos. Well, in fact, Colonel Marcos, yung Colonel Laraga was demoted in that operation, but he was just suspended for 4 months. Diba? Ikaw, Colonel Vitalio, o saan ka na-assign na maraming namatay? Diba you were assigned Laguna?
Mr. Chair, binyan po ako siya noon.
O, Binyan. Laguna nga?
Yes, sir, Laguna.
O, then you were assigned in Rizal. Tama?
Kainta, sir.
O. Ang request ko lang dito, nandito kasi yung lahat na records nyo eh. Tapos, magkatugma doon sa nangyari, napatayan, yung mga namamatay. Kaya, I also understand that during the time, yung basic na instinct ng isang opisyal is promotion, of course, some perks, Or else, i-assign ka dun sa malalayo, or, worst is, kakasuhan ka. And that happens, I have now the records. Lahat po, kahit yung kaklase nyo, kaya nga sabi ko noon kaan, 96, 97, marami pong magagaling dyan. Marami. Marami magagaling. But of course, some of you were forced during that time. Naintindihan ko yun. Naintindihan ko yun. But of course, you cannot lie because we have all your assignments and all the deaths happen in your assignment. But sabi ko na nga, you are forced to do it because or else, yung isa niyong kanyang kaklase o underclass niyong isa, he was dismissed because of, alam mo ano? Yung pota. Oh. Ginawa siya ng problema. It turned out ngayon, yung motion niya, motion for reconsideration niya, was considered. Kasi, ang basis is all about the quota. Ayun yung sinasabi ko. At least, ako ang sinasabi ko lang, alam na po namin lahat. Lalo na po ngayon si Ma'am Garma has already issued his affidavit. Mayroon pa po. I hope you understand. And don't force us to cite it in contempt. Kasi, ano na ngayon dito? Punong-puno na po. Ako, sinasabi ko, naintindihan ko kayo during the time. But this time, we don't want this to happen again, even in the next administration. Whoever sits in Malacanang. And I ask you to help us. Because this is not for me. This is not for the Quadcom. This is not for the House of Congress. This is for the people of this country. Yun lang po. Sana po you cooperate. And you execute your affidavit so that we can now end this interpellation. Kasi darating din tayo dun. Sabi nga ni Chairman Akop nung nakaraan, aabot din tayo doon. Yeah. Anyway, Mr. Chairman, I hope yung mga nandito, and don't you know, kahit si Colonel Tom Tungson wala dito, papatawag din siya. Kasi kayo lang nabanggit nung nakaraan. Kaya sinasabi na namin, kung hindi nyo pwedeng sabihin, in open hearing, you execute voluntarily your affidavit. Kasi ganun din po, lalabas at lalabas din. Well, now, Mr. Chairman, that's all. I hope the gentleman in the PNP understand my position and my statement, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Padano. Continue. Okay. Right. Please continue, Congressman.
Can you kindly show the diagram? I just wanted to be clarified on something. Because Rowena, Ma'am Rowena, Miss Rowena Garma, no? Ito yung binigay mo. Did you do this diagram? Ikaw yung gumawa ng diagram. Itong diagram na nakita namin dito that you have submitted, parang...
As far as I just simplified my affidavit in a...
O kasi dito sa ano mo, I was trying to look at your affidavit. At this affidavit mo sa page as a page 3 number 25, minensyon mo dito si Peter Parungo.
Yes po.
Si Peter Parungo na binanggit mo dito, ang sinasabi mo, one task force began operation. I later learned that all Copeland funds, refund for operational expenses and rewards for agents were processed through the bank accounts of Peter Parungo at Metrobank, BDO, and PS Bank. So, ibig sabihin, itong Peter Parungo, pag titignan mo yung diagram, hindi ko siya makita doon. So, can you kindly explain where this Peter Parungo and who is Peter Parungo? Yes, at ano yung kanyang role? Siya ba'y tumatanggap ng pera? Kanino nang gagaling ang pera? Kano binibigay ang pera? Can you kindly tell us?
The one in green po, Peter Parungo, Pedro, known as Pedro po.
Ah, yun nasa kulay green na sa kaliwa.
Yes po.
Yun ang Peter Parungo.
Yes.
At na nanggagaling ang instruction at ang pera doon kay Alias Muking.
Mr. Chair, that is how Pedro described it to me when one time I was at CIDG and parang nagkaambot ng ulo, sir. Sabi ko,
ano sabi niya?
Sabi ko, uy, bakit? Naku, ma'am, baka ma-unlock na ako. Kasi every week, malalaking amount na pumapasok. Saan? Sa bangko, ma'am. Metrobank, ganyan. Balak na nga mag-open pang ano, ibang bank. To sabi ko na, sabi ko, di mahirap yan pag ganyan. Ganyan ko siya. Kasi nahirapan na siya kasi nga sobrang dami na pumapasok. Yun ang reklamo niya na kamot ulo palabas ng opisina that time. And I was just outside the office. I asked him kung bakit ganun ang behavior niya eh. That's where I learned na siya pala ang pinupuntahan ng pera.
So, sinabi niya na si Yusek Muking, SP na o Espino.
Sabi siya, sabi niya.
Ang naglalagay ng pera.
Muking, kasi po, yun ang instruction sa kanya.
So, Mr. Chairman, I think this Pedro Parungo is so crucial that we need to invite him as well. At nakalagay dito sa alias Pedro, CIDG 11 personnel in charge in the deposit and payment of money coming from alias Muking from PMS who in charge in releasing of money. Binanggit ba sa iyo kung saan ang galing yung pera ni Muking?
Wala po. Si Pedro, yun lang po ang sinabi. Actually, hindi po personnel po ng CIDG si Pedro. Parang trustee lang po during that time.
So, si Pedro Muking...
Hindi po siya organic.
Si Pedro Parungo, hindi siya PNP personnel.
Hindi. Hindi rin po siya NUP. Hindi.
Ito yung may kaso ng rape.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Correct? Yes. Okay. With that, Mr. Chairman, I reiterate my request, no? And to invite this person, Peter Parungo.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, Congressman Akop, with the indulgence of
Congressman. Before we leave, Mr. Parungo.
Yes.
Ang may tao kay Peter Parungo ay si Colonel Leonardo.
Opo, Mr. Chair.
Pero palaging nandun siya sa PCSO, di ba?
Hindi po, Mr. Chair. Hindi po palagi. I think, alam ko na po kung ano yung next question. Actually, noong 2019, when I assumed as PCSO, nag-wrap up na po yung war on drugs. I think tatanggalin na siya kasi wala na siyang role. And then, nakiusap po na baka pwede, ma'am, magtrabaho na lang ako with PCSO kasi wala na. Wala na akong tasking or whatever, sabi niya. O sige, sabi ko, I need liaison in Davao. Kasi sa mga relief goods operation, we will distribute and etc. So, I hired him, Mr. Chair. Kasi wala na siyang work.
Kasi before that, nagtatrabaho siya kay Colonel Leonardo.
Yes, sir. Kasi nasa CIDG talaga siya, Mr. Chair. Yes, po.
Kumbaga sa kwan, kasi ugali ng mga opisyal, meron silang, ano na tawag dun sa opisyal na parang handyman, inuutusan nila palagi. Di ba? Hindi, may tawag sila eh. Kalimutan ko na lang.
Runner?
Ha?
Striker.
Oh, yes. Maski lahat ng opisina dyan sa Krami, meron ding striker. So, striker si Peter Parungo. Pero, kung ipapahanap natin sa AMLAC yung bank or financial transaction doon sa tatlong banko na binabanggit, malaki yung pera doon. Thank you, Honorable.
That is educational, Chairman Acop. So, ma'am, Rohina, binanggit mo rin dito si Romel Baktat, si Rodel Serbo, si Michael Palma, at yun na nga, si Peter Parungo, were charged with the task of collecting and verifying information provided by police officers in the field concerning arrests or deaths of individuals named in the list of drug personalities and creating a summary report. All of these reports would been encoded and compiled by Lester Bergaño. The compilation is thereafter elevated to Leonardo, who will decide what level the arrest or killing was and its corresponding reward. Is this correct? Papidabit mo to eh.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay.
Ang dalawa kasi po yung report na pumapasok po is yung report na mayroon ng encounter sa ground and yung report po ng mga receive intel report for validation, for confirmation, or para establish kung anong level for encoding po or listing sa list. At so, dalawa po yung report na pumapasok. Yung namatay at saka yung for listing and for verification and validation po.
Paano mo naman nakilala si Romel Baktat, si Rodel Serbo, si Michael Palma, and Peter Barungo?
These are all organic personnel of CIDG 11 and I work with CIDG 11 noon. Nandun na rin sila. And ito po yung mga taong... tao ni sir talaga.
So itong tatlo, nakasagay din dito, si Romel Baktat, Rodel Serbo, Michael Palma, are former policemen.
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chairman, in that case, Mr. Chairman, I move that we invite also Romel Baktat, Rodel Serbo, Michael Palma, and of course, yan nga po, si Peter Barungo. Ito po yung task force. Sila ang task force.
Wala pong task force, Mr. Chair. Ang nangyari lang po is naging depository of information, data, validation of reports, yung CIDG 11.
Sila yung operatives?
Yeah, to maintain the list, to you know, ganun po ang role nila. Sila yung dedicated, in addition to their job, dedicated po to handle.
And binanggit mo rin dito sa 26, matatapos na tayo, si Leonardo conducted briefings for PIDEA, IG, regional directors, and PNP chiefs. PNP chiefs?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Si
mga incoming po.
Siya ang nag-conduct ng briefing?
Yes po, Mr. Chair. Meron po kasing extensive research po ginawa si Sir. Meron po yung confidential na book na yan po yung ginagamit niya to brief po mga RDs, R2s, chief PNPs, incoming chief PNPs po, para ma-appraise po sila kung ano po yung present drug situation and operation sa bansa po.
Okay. Do you have knowledge kung sino yung mga na-brief niya sa PIDEA, sa IG, sa... Doon na lang sa PIDEA, sino yung mga na-brief ni...
Mr. Chair, I think sa record, makikita naman po natin kung sino po yung mga umupo na mga directors during that time. I cannot actually memorize it po, sir.
Sige, thank you. Do you have also knowledge about those other personalities who have been killed on the war on drugs? Like big personalities that you know about?
Yes, Mr. Chair, it was a public knowledge. It was in the newspaper like the couple na Odicta, di ba namatay po yun? Mayor Halili, mayors.
Sa Calabarzon yan, Tony Halili?
Region 4A.
Yes, anong alam mo sa pagkamatay ni Tony Halili?
It was, he was shot during the flag raising ceremony.
Yes, yes, it was reported.
Sniper po.
So, what do you know about the...
Chismis lang kasi, Mr. Chair.
Ah, okay.
And I think imported. Kasi during that time po sa war on drugs, pwede pong tumawid yung mga operatives.
So wala kang direct knowledge about it? Wala kang direct knowledge about it?
Pinagmalaki kasi ng isa, sir, eh, na
sino,
sila.
Sino yung nagmalaking yun?
Major Albotra, Mr. Chair.
Major?
Albotra of Region 7.
Albotra?
Yes.
Of Region 7?
Yes po. Ano pangalan ni Albotra?
Major Albotra ng Region 7.
Lieutenant Colonel nata. Yes, pinagmalaki niya sa akin noon. Oh, talaga, sabi ko, how did you do it? So, mga kilala niya, mga kasama niya.
At sila ang nagpapatay kay Tony Halili?
He said he's in the team, Mr. Chair.
So, it's a team that killed Mayor Tony Halili. So
according
it was really
him,
a planned...
according to him, Mr. Chair.
According to
during
Major,
that time kasi, Mr. Chair, kung meron ng grapevine, like it would appear na it is a operation, nagkakaroon ng code of silence. It's real talk, Mr. Chair, sa PNP. Tahimik na. Matatakot na yung iba, matatakot na rin. Even RDs would say na, oh, trabaho yan. Oh, huwag mong ano, trabaho. They will call, just call you and then it became a culture. Minsan i-process kasi mag-intervene ang NBI. Mas nakakatuwa nga kung NBI kasi talagang mas maganda pag ganun. Kaya during my time sa CIDG, nasa Cebu City Police ako, tuwang-tuwa ako pag NBI talaga mag-handle. Kasi definitely, magiging maayos po. That is why, sinasabi ko palagi, gusto ko nagka-hands off after the processing ng crime scene ng crime lab. Pag sinabi na victim na they want NBI, binibigay ko po. That's how it, that's the reality on the ground, Mr. Chair. You can ask mga ground commanders and chief of police.
So again, Mr. Chairman, I would like to reiterate the name of Major...
Colonel, Lieutenant Colonel Albotra na atang.
Albotra. Kenneth Albotra to be invited in the next hearing.
Comsec, please take note.
With that, Mr. Chairman, with a heavy heart, I yield back. For the meantime.
Okay, thank you, Congressman Fernandez. May tanong lang ko kay Colonel Marcos. Colonel Marcos. Yung bang prior to your assignment sa Region 8, you're the regional what do you call that? Anong position ni ano?
Regional
chief ng CIDG sa Region 8.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Prior to that, anong assignment mo?
Deputy Provincial Director po of Leyte PPO, sir.
Ah, so sa PPO ka dati. Opo, and then eventually nung after 2016 napunta ka sa CIDG as regional chief.
By July, sir.
July of 2016.
Yes, sir.
Kanina kasi nabanggit ni Colonel Garma na ang tinatanong ko kasi, paano ba nagkakaroon ng assignment? No, halimbawa, in example ko kasi kanina, si Colonel Patay, from Davao del Norte, inailipat siya dito sa Quezon City. So, ang sagot sa akin ni Colonel Garma, mayroong mga nagbo-volunteer. Example daw niya, kagaya mo, nag-volunteer ka dyan sa Region 8 because kaya mo raw mag-deliver. And in the lingo of the members of the PNP, nagkakaintindihan kayo pagka pinag-usapan yung deliver. Tama ba yun? Is it safe to assume na yung sinasabing deliver ay yung merong mga drug personalities na may execute ninyo?
Bali po sir, yung ibig sabihin ng linggo ng deliver sa amin is pag kinuha ka sir na nilagay ka sa isang post na operating unit, you know how to operate sir. Marunong kang kumaga, you can perform the performance of an operating unit. Parang ganun sir.
So it doesn't have anything to do with killing?
Hindi naman po sa pagkaintindi ko ganun sir. Kasi hindi pa ako na-assign ng CIDG ever since in my career. Kaya nung sinabi na kung willing ako ma-assign ng CIDG, nag-oo po ako sir.
Pero totoo ba na nag-volunteer ka na mapuesto ka dyan as regional chief kasi you can deliver? Totoo ba yan?
Sinutan ako, sir, ng order. Bali, yun pong nangyayari po kasi noon is nangyayari naman po yan ng shoot order. Ang normal process po kasi sa PNP is you seek for an accommodation, then you seek for an availability. Ang nangyayari po sa akin is shoot order po. Marami po kami nasyutan ng order because it was a transition, sir. Nangyayari naman po yan sa transition of government. Pagbago po yung leadership, minsan, yung mga gusto nilang ipwesto, pwepwesto po nila.
Were you ever assigned outside of Region 8? Saan ka ba na-assigned dati?
I was assigned, sir, in Malacañang as PSD member during President Ramos' time. Then after that, I was assigned with Region 8 as company commander. Then I was assigned with Region 7. Then I was assigned, sir, in DPRM, NHQ. Then I was assigned with NCRPO, Manila Police. Then I went back, sir, to Region 8 on my hometown after my OSEC. Yun po yung mga assignment ko, sir.
Mr. Chair,
pwede bang... Oh, yeah, please. Congressman ako.
Na-assign ka sa Malacañang?
Yes, sir.
After graduation?
Yes, sir.
For how many months?
For almost 2 years, sir. From 1996 up to late 1997.
Are you sure?
Sir?
Sigurado ka?
Opo, sir. Halos, sir, kinuha kami noon, sir, ng PSG kasi because of the APEC.
Yes. Yeah, yun ang totoo.
Opo, sir.
Yung buong class ninyo kinuha dahil may international activity na mangyayari noon dito sa ating bansa.
Opo, sir.
And you lasted for 2 years?
More than, sir. Hindi umabot, sir. Before
paano yung more than na hindi umabot?
Bali, hanggang March of 1997, sir?
Tinatanong ko lang naman kung 2 years. Sabi mo, hindi magkaugmay yung sagot mo kasi. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Congressman Acop. So, the next to interpellate is Congressman Lordan Suwan. You have 10 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. May I ask, Ms. Garma, again, why were you crying as you were reading your affidavit earlier?
Because, Mr. Chair, it took me more than a week to make some reflections, and it's very difficult to have the courage po. So although I have decided naman po, I think it has something to do with my courage to come out po.
What convinced you to come out?
Sabi ko nga, I made some reflections, and I have to go back to yung values ko na lagi ko sinasabi, at sinasabi ko rin sa anak ko palagi, and even to my relatives, I would always say the truth, because the truth will set you free. And that was the same statement that my daughter told me before I appeared before this Quadcom, Mr. Chair. So, nakaroon po lang ng time when I was inside the detention facility of the Congress to reflect, Mr. Chair.
I commend you for your courage, Ms. Garma. And you also mentioned earlier that you were afraid for your life. Were there threats made against you?
Mr. Chair, right now there is no threat. But knowing the capability of those persons that I have mentioned, they are in position, some of them are in position, they have the assets, capability, and influence, Mr. Chair. At ngayon po, I'm just a mere ordinary person lang po ako. I don't have position, I don't have power, ganun din po ang mga relatives ko, and sino ba namang hindi rin matakot, which is normal po.
In paragraph number 13, you said that Mr. Leonardo informed you that he stayed at a hotel for 3 days, during which the president directed him to organize a task force similar to the PAOC-TF. So what is the name of this new task force?
Wala po, Mr. Chair, hindi na po nalagyan ng pangalan. Kasi naging simple na lang po na sa CIDG Region 11 na lang po ang parang pinaka, how to call this, parang pinaka focal area or focal point. So hindi na siya ganun ka-structured na may mga specific officers to handle per area. Kasi na-mobilize din po mismo na yung RD, yung PD, and Chief of Police.
So itong task force na sinasabi niyo po,
hindi po nagawa po yan.
Hindi siya nagawa, or meron pa rin team pero hindi siya official?
Yung team po, it's more on consolidation, encoders, in charge in the payout, monitoring, mga ganun na lang po na simplify ang setup po dun sa office ng CIDG 11.
Tapos sinabi nyo, so nandun sila sa CIDG 11.
Yes,
so parang may parallel force dun sa CIDG 11 na secret na gumagawa ng ganitong war on drugs.
Hindi naman po secret, Mr. Chair, kasi lahat naman ng Chief PNP, RD, PD, Chief of Police, alam naman nila eh, na nandun talaga. It's not a secret. It's known sa lahat po ng officers yan. So happened na in addition to their mga duties, nadagdagan lang po. Yan po.
Yung sa Region 11, CIDG?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
In paragraph number 14, you said that when Leonardo relayed this information and urged me to join the task force, you refused, right?
Opo, Mr. Chair.
And you said that your reason for refusing is your lack of experience in handling such operations. But was there any other reason why you refused to be a part of this?
Yes, Mr. Chair, aside from that, kasi during the time, there was an instruction from the President. I was there, Bongo and Leonardo was also there. When the President mentioned to us that he wants me to join the team sa Malacanang to handle police and military affairs. Kasi po, sabi niya, it's too much kay Sen Bongo na na-handle lahat ng ahensya. So because of that, hindi ka naman din makatanggi kung ganyanin ka. Point, sabi ko, yes lang ako na yes. So sabi ko, if there is an order, I will comply po, sir, sabi ko. So there was an order issued by the ILG actually, which I complied for a while.
Anong order po yun?
The ILG order that I am detailed to the office of the sa President.
Sa President?
Yes po. Pero hindi rin po nagtagal kasi po, nagkaroon din po ako ng order na na-reassign na ako sa Region 7 CIDG after my graduation sa OSEC.
Okay. And then you were assigned as Police Chief of Cebu.
And then a year and a half after, naging Chief of City Director po ako ng Cebu City. In fact, that was actually offered to me by General Sinas, yung position na city director. I have no intention or interest to the position, but since it was offered and I realized po na magandang break po sa career kasi city director. So actually, it took me for a while eh, para pag-isipan kasi during that time po, yung Region 7 na CIDG ay located lang po sa loob din mismo na Cebu City. At nakikita ko po na napakalaki ng problema ng Cebu City. And I was thinking kung makakayanan ko ba na i-handle yung administrative and operational concerns and issues ng Cebu City, which is during that time naman po, si General Sinas is very supportive. I have high respect on him. And sabi ko, mukhang maganda magtrabaho with him because marunong siyang mag-support sa mga tao sa ground during that time.
Why were there a lot of deaths during your time as Chief of Police in Cebu?
During that time po, sa Cebu City, I think there was this intense police operation. Kasi hindi lang naman po Cebu City po, Mr. Chair. Kung titingnan mo kasi yung statistics, pag nangyari sa Cebu Island, naging Cebu City ang tingin. Pero kung himay-himayin mo po yung statistics, makikita mo na lapu-lapu pala siya, Mandaue, Cebu City, Cebu Province. Pero pag sinabi mo kasi Cebu, it appeared po na buong Cebu City. And then during that time po, hindi lang po ang police station na nag-ooperate. Meron po tayong ARSOG, Regional Special Operation Group, which is being managed by all ARTUS. Tapos meron pang PISOG, like Provincial Special Operations Group. And then meron pang PIDEG na nag-ooperate. May CIDG din na may territory per province. So, pag makikita mo po yung statistics, it would be... Ako po, maganda rin tignan po, sino nag-operate para makita natin kung sino yung liable. Kasi pag titignan mo ko yung statistics, kukunin mo, kung saang territory, it appeared na yung police station na yon ang may gawa o may trabaho.
So, pero may iba-iba pa lang mga organizations na naka-overlap.
Yes, Mr.
Sa same geographical area.
Yes, Mr. Chair, saka ina-allow during that time yung tatawid ka ng area as long as you coordinate sa mas mataas na level. So halimbawa, ako Cebu City, yung drug personality ko na target ko sa Cebu City ay nandun pala sa Cebu Province, I will just ask clearance sa regional office and coordinate with the provincial officer so I could go in, sa territory niya. So that's how it works. Same with from one region to another region. Minsan from Luzon, pumupunta pa po ng Mindanao, Mindanao to Visayas. Ganun po noon ka-aggressive yung campaign.
Okay. You said in paragraph 21 that during the initial 3 months of his assignment, you facilitated all meetings between Leonardo and Bongo at Leonardo's request. What did they meet about?
Hindi po ako kasama sa mga meetings, Mr. Chair. I will just ask for a schedule para sa kanya po. Hindi po ako kasama. But after the meeting naman na pag-uusapan, na pagkukwentuhan,
anong more on, kinikwento?
Kasi kung halimbawa, Dai, paki-arrange mo ako ng meeting, isasubmit ko lang ito, itong like structure, or I will submit a report, or I will update them.
Kanino daw niya isasubmit?
Kay Sir, kay Bongo po. Mag-updating siya,
yung report siya ng report. Ano po?
I do not know, Mr. Chair, kung ano yung laman. And I do not know din po kung ano yung update.
Pero hindi yun report sa regular police work?
I feel that hindi. Kasi siya na po, ina-task na po siya eh. So it has something to do with the special task po.
In paragraph 22, you said that Leonardo informed you that he had recalled several trusted personnel, namely Lester Berganio and several others, to serve as operatives for the task force. Is this task force above board or is this an assassination task force?
It's not po assassination task force. As I mentioned po, it's just, these are staffs that will handle po yung recording, parang depository of all information and data so that kung halimbawa po na may operation sa ground, pwede mong i-verify if this person is on the list. Mga ganun lang po. Or if you want to submit a list for validation or what, pwede mo rin gawin po yun. Kasi may capability naman po yung opisina ni Sir
yung
to validate all information because he's in control po sa buong Pilipinas na R2, RDs, and other units po.
Okay. And here in paragraph 22.2, you said that all of these reports would then be encoded and compiled by Lester Berganio. Is Lester Berganio here?
Wala po. It's just a civilian hired lang po to encode everything. That was during the time po, yun po nakita ko na siya po yung nag-handle. I just do not know sa later part po because what I am talking in my affidavit is the first 3 months na observation.
First 3 months
po.
Lang?
Yes po.
Sabi niyo po dito na the compilation is thereafter elevated to Leonardo who will decide what level the arrest or killing was and its corresponding reward. So rewards were only given for killings. While for arrests, only the funding of the co-plan and a refund of the expenses were given. So you're saying that rewards, there is no reward if you arrest. Wala pong reward.
Opo.
Refund lang.
Refund, depende po kasi kaya before you conduct the operation, you need to submit the co-plan so that it will be funded po.
Okay. Pero kung may mamatay, may reward.
Meron pong binibigay, may pinapadala po dun sa operatiba po na nakipag-communicate.
Okay. I think this is very important, this list of Mr. Lester Berganio, because we could get an estimate of the real number of casualties from the perspective of those who were responsible of the EJ case. May I manifest, Mr. Chair, that we invite Mr. Lester Berganio?
Comsec, please take note of the request of Congressman Suwan.
And you also said, Ms. Garma, in 22.3, I saw how these individuals operated when I would visit the CIDG office in Region 11 to see my friend Lot. So... How did you know, how did you see how they operated? Did you go with them? Did you observe for days? What?
Hindi po. There are times kasi po that mag-standby po ako doon because my friend was there. And during that time po, since na halos wala po akong klase, kung hapon, kung minsan po, doon po ako naghihintay kasi susunduin ko yung anak ko sa school. So, nakikita ko po ang how they work, how they work inside.
Do you have any memories? For example, something that stuck to you when you were there? Parang isang maganda, isang memory na something that happened that was memorable for you na hindi mo makalimutan?
Wala po akong maalala, Mr. Chief.
Wala.
Wala po, okay. Your Honor.
You also said here that in paragraph 25, Lester Berganio maintained a comprehensive list of drug personalities in the Philippines. Tama po ba?
During that time po, siya po yung encoder. So,
sabi mo, maintained a comprehensive list
yes
of
po.
Drug personalities.
Yes.
So would it be safe to say that he is the progenitor of the drug list? Siya yung parang unang gumawa ng drug list?
Encoder lang po kasi siya. So kung ano lang ibigay, siya lang po ang nag-encode, Mr. Chair.
Sinong nagbibigay?
Bibigay nila, sir, po. Kasi encoder lang siya eh.
Yung team nila, Leonardo?
Yes po. I do not know kung anong maging arrangement or instruction, but he's just a mere encoder.
Okay. And it relates to paragraph 27 where you said that Leonardo had the final authority to determine who would be included on the list of drug personalities and to classify their threat levels, as well as the discretion to remove individuals from the list. So you're saying that Leonardo, Police Colonel Leonardo, is the progenitor or the author of the original drug list?
Hindi po siya yung original kasi yung una pong binasa ni Presidente, hindi po galing kay si Leonardo yun.
Pero paano tong sinabi nyo na may final authority siya to determine who would be included?
When he was tasked na po, after the announcement, and then nung tinas na po siya, I think that was yung unang binasa po ni Presidente, dun po nagsimula yung yung unang list, and then na-update na lang po every week, every month, ganyan po, hanggang sa dumami ng dumami because the reports were coming na po sa different units and others are for validation, ganun po. So, na-update na na-update po.
Okay, so, yung binasa ni Presidente na list, galing na yon kay Leonardo?
Hindi po, Mr. Chair. Yung una, hindi po.
Yung unang binasa
ng TV? We do not know kung saan po galing po yun. He just
yung
read
list,
it.
Hindi nyo alam? Okay. So, just a couple more questions, Mr. Chair.
You have 2 minutes.
Were you ever directly involved in operations where suspects were neutralized as part of the drug war?
Wala po. Wala po maalala.
Hindi ka involved dun sa yung tatlong Chinese drug lords sa Dapecol?
Hindi po, Mr. Chair.
How about kay Wesley Barayuga?
Hindi rin po, Mr. Chair, Your Honor.
And last question. You mentioned that certain national figures had the final authority to determine the level of arrests or killings. Can you testify on any specific instances where national leadership directly approved the killing of certain suspects? May situation ba na may order galing sa taas na i-eliminate ang isang suspect?
Wala pa akong alam na meron pong ganun, Your Honor.
Sino pong may alam doon?
Wala pa akong alam, Your Honor.
Okay. No more questions, Mr. Chair.